paper it's written on. A review panel has concluded the government's plan to roll out high-speed broadband has greater economic benefits for Australia than Labor's model. The Communications Minister Malcolm Turnbull spoke about the analysis on ABC Radio's AM program this morning.
Certainly confirms the decision by the government to proceed with a multi-technology mix and not persevere with Labor's plan to take fibre into 93% of premises. On a financial basis, purely financial basis, that saves over $30 billion. And when you do the cost-benefit analysis, which has been done now and completed, which takes into account all of the social benefits to the whole society, e-health, education, the works, even on that basis, the approach we're taking is $16 billion better. That's to say, Australians are $16 billion better off by taking the approach we're taking. Now, the tragedy, of course, is that this work was not done before Labor embarked on the NBN project back in 2009. I mean, this is a great piece of work, but it would have saved tens of billions if it had been done four or five years ago.
It's certainly a great piece of work for your argument. But the report does say that providing wireless services to the bush exceeds the benefits by almost $7,000 a household. Is that sustainable over the long term?
Well, it's a subsidy. There's no question about that. It's the government, the nation can afford it. We can afford that cross-subsidy. But it's undoubtedly true. The cost of providing telecommunications to regional and rural areas is dramatically higher than people's capacity or willingness to pay.
But hence, that's something you're prepared to wear.
There's a big subsidy.
I mean, if you do a cost-benefit analysis like they did, they found a better return would come from an entirely unsubsidised rollout. And, of course, that's true, isn't it?
It would, but that would result in people in those areas having very poor telecommunications, and that's not acceptable in Australia. But it's good to iron up. When you're making a big subsidy to anybody or any area, it's important to be clear-eyed and open about what you're doing. And this is a very significant subsidy in the order of $5 billion.
The political reality for you, though, is that you couldn't not do that with your National Party colleagues in the coalition.
Regardless of the politics, we wouldn't want to do it. I mean, it is access to telecommunications and to broadband is a very, very fundamental need for people living in a modern society like Australia.